He was so much fun.
It's hard for Loma Hopkins to walk the grounds of Summit School.
He was just my style.
The theater teacher recalls a lot after teaching for 48 years. But one student stands out.
Of course Matthew stood out, and I'm not just saying this because Matthew is not with us anymore.
She says Matthew Gfeller stood out for his versatility in the class, on the field, and even on stage.
Bertie, what are you doing to my wife?
Matt was an 8th and 9th grader here. And that's not an age when boys usually love to get up and be the center of attention, although he liked music and drama.
Before graduating this spring, Gfeller stole the show in this production of Bye Bye Birdie.
It never felt like this. No, never felt like this.
Hopkins says the 15-year-old didn't want the starring role. She recalls the preparation she provided the star athlete turned actor.
We were in the music room and we were in there, all three of us gyrating, which must have been a sight to see if anybody had been watching us. So, well, we were learning to move our hips. And about halfway through, he said, "Stop. I can't believe I'm doing this. I can't believe I'm enjoying it."
And from this production, he wiggled well. That's why Hopkins couldn't believe the phone call she received telling her star actor was injured playing in his first game of the year for R.J. Reynolds.
I thought of Matt. He was strong. He was a vibrant person. He was young, healthy. And I thought, Matt will be all right.
But the block on the field left Gfeller with severe brain injuries. He wasn't all right. He held on for a few hours after doctors took him off life support.
Even now, I think of Matt as alive.
He died Sunday morning, leaving a void. But memories last forever. Hopkins says this loss is a total shock and serves as a reminder of how precious life is.
That we need to be positive and happy that we were able to be with Matt for as long as we were.